Hi, I'm Palab. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we look at the concepts of consumer surplus, producer surplus, total surplus, and deadweight loss of taxes. Remember that the effects of taxes are unchanged whether they are placed on the producer or the consumer. Taxes lead to consumers paying a higher price than the producer receives, meaning there will always be a gap between the two costs. Imposing taxes also result in comparatively lower quantity sold. To look at the effects of taxes on welfare, look at this figure. Without tax, equilibrium occurs at a price of PE and quantity of QE. When there is a tax of size $T, the equilibrium changes slightly. The price that buyers pay is now PB. The price that sellers receive is now PS. The equilibrium quantity is now at QT. The revenue from tax is given at $T and QT. We can apply the welfare theory to measure the gains and losses from a tax. Remember that the equilibrium price PE determines surplus. The space below PE and above the supply curve is the producer surplus, while consumer surplus equals the range from PE to the demand curve. Without the tax, CS is represented by the area A plus B plus C, and PS is the area D plus E plus F. The total surplus, TS, is equal to A plus B plus C plus D plus E plus F. Since there is no tax, the tax revenue is $0. When there is a tax of T dollar, the CS is given by the area A, and PS is the area F. The TS, which equals CS plus PS, is equal to A plus F. The tax revenue then is equal to the area B plus T. Because of tax, the units between QT and QE are not sold. Comparing the outcome with and without tax, the total surplus falls by the area C plus E once tax is implemented. Area C plus E is also known as the deadweight loss DWL of the tax. This area is the drop in total surplus when compared to the outcome without tax. Taxes lead to deadweight loss because they limit the extent of benefits available to consumers and producers in a given trade. It's easy to confuse the area that represents the deadweight loss of taxes. Keep in mind that the deadweight loss of tax is found by locating the area between the equilibrium quantity before the tax is imposed and the new equilibrium quantity after the tax is imposed. I hope our lesson today on the effects of taxes on equilibrium and trade outcomes has helped you better understand the implication of taxes on the welfare of society. If you want to explore these topics more in depth, come visit Chegg, where you can see additional topic videos and pre-solved example problems. Or you can ask specific questions of one of the Chegg subject matter experts. I hope to see you soon at Chegg.